Hello and thank you for tuning in. I'm Mrs. Jones and I have the great privilege of being the head teacher at St. Joseph's College. St. Joseph's College has a very proud history, and in this modern world we have retained what is best from the past, the tradition of academic excellence in particular, and the emphasis on the learner as an individual. The main building of the school is over 100 years old, but recently the whole school campus has been redeveloped and it now houses the most modern of facilities, technologies, and indeed teaching methodologies. In a world which is constantly changing, we are educating young people for jobs that do not yet exist, to use technologies that are not yet invented, and to solve problems we do not yet know are problems. As a consequence, it is essential that we develop in young people the skills that they need to succeed in the future. And to this end, we are fully committed to delivering our curriculum for excellence. Our young people will need to be creative, resourceful, flexible, confident, and responsible to succeed in a global economy. Hence, in St. Joseph's, we aim to maximise opportunities for pupils to build these skills. We work hard to provide a curriculum which is challenging, yet enjoyable, and which enables pupils to pursue their strengths and talents and make progress at a brisk pace. I'm always impressed by the professionalism of staff, by the support they give to the children in their care, and by their contribution to the positive school ethos. In partnership with parents and carers, the school aims to provide an environment and a range of opportunities which promote the moral, physical, social and intellectual development of all its students. Our aims extend to the transmission of values for life based on Christian principles. These centre around key concepts which are inclusive: the life, dignity and voice of each person, justice and peace, and service to others. The development of each individual and the whole child is very important to us. And that is why we value the support provided by a number of bodies, including our Parent Council, which also incorporates our active Parents and Friends Association. We very much value and recognise the benefits of developing good partnerships with parents and carers, and appreciate their involvement in, for example, developing school policies on such matters as promoting positive relationships, homework, and the use of mobile devices. We are also supported in our work by a number of partner agencies, including Skills Development Scotland, the NHS and the Police Service. Our Link Community Police Officer is welcomed by pupils, staff and parents. Not only is he a friendly face around the campus, but he also delivers lessons on responsible citizenship through our social education programme. In addition, he takes the lead in training senior pupils in the National Mentors for the Prevention of Violence scheme. I'm very aware that this time represents for you as parents, and most importantly for Primary 7 pupils, a time of great change. The youngsters are about to embark on a stage in their lives that will bring them into a bigger and broader community, and will eventually help them to develop into adults. I'm sure many of us remember the feelings we experienced when we moved from primary to secondary school. I'm sure our parents had a few apprehensions too. In this context, we are particularly careful about the preparation for the move to secondary, and a lot of groundwork takes place to ensure a smooth transition. Detailed information is gathered from primary schools by our personal support for pupil staff. And thanks to this and thorough preparation, our newcomers always settle quickly, regardless of which of the many schools they arrive from. Despite our current COVID-related challenges, we are very optimistic that in June 2021, we will be able to welcome the Primary 7 pupils for 3 induction days at St. Joseph's College. During this time, the pupils will meet their peers, who will soon become their friends. We want our students to show that they are proud to belong to St. Joseph's College, and there are many ways in which pupils do this. The first and most visible sign is by wearing the school uniform, which pupils are expected to comply with at all times. As mentioned earlier, we have a fine academic tradition, which ensures that pupils do very well indeed in national examinations, as verified by statistical data which makes comparisons across Scotland. Students benefit greatly from the very wide range of courses on offer, both within the school and through part of being of Dumfries Learning Town, which includes partnerships with Dumfries and Galloway College. Out with the formal curriculum, the school offers many opportunities for personal development through active participation in a wide range of extracurricular activities. Pupils take part in a number of trips to places like Hadrian's Wall, the Highland Show and Stirling Castle. The creative and aesthetic curriculum is also enhanced by pupils visiting museums and the theatre for films, plays and musicals. Residential trips are offered to all year groups to places such as Belgium for a World War I battlefields tour, Iceland for the geographers and Italy for the skiers. Groups also take off to London, New York and Paris, where they experience some French culture, and Disneyland, which is always a firm favourite with the younger pupils. Many sports are on offer, with an emphasis on participation and team spirit in the traditional areas of football, rugby, hockey, netball and basketball. As well as team sports, pupils have the opportunity to participate in, for example, orienteering, badminton, swimming, athletics and table tennis. Sports Day is an annual highlight, with almost all pupils and staff participating in some way or another. Our very active science department has developed very good links with a number of universities, which has resulted in pupils gaining excellent laboratory experience, and many students take up the opportunity to become young STEM leaders, which involves them in helping to run lunchtime science clubs for junior pupils. The college also encourages the growth of entrepreneurial skills through a variety of courses and challenges in maths, science, business education and home economics. Leadership and citizenship skills are developed through participation in such activities as the junior and senior pupil councils, captain and prefect teams, eco group and the charities committee, which runs annual events such as our busy Christmas market and Strictly St Joseph's. The excellent voluntary work being carried out by many of our pupils from S1 to S6 is now formally recognised through Dynamic Youth Awards, Saltire Awards, the Caritas Awards Scheme and the Duke of Edinburgh's Awards Scheme. Of course, we also attach great importance to the development of social skills, and there are many opportunities for enjoyable occasions. In particular, Christmas lunches and Cayleys are highlights of the school's social calendar, as are activities organised by pupil teams, such as the extremely popular but very scary Halloween Fright Night. Musical talent is certainly encouraged, and pupils have the opportunity to participate in a range of activities, including the school band, percussion and guitar groups, and the community choir. Pupils have the opportunity to express and display their creativity in art and on the stage in plays and pantomimes. Following on from our previous highly acclaimed productions of the likes of Oliver, Bugsy Malone, We Will Rock You and Hairspray, Greece should have been the word in 2020, but is now on hold until once again pupils will take to both front and backstage in large numbers and create memories that will last a lifetime. I hope I've been able to give you a flavour of life in St Joseph's College, where we encourage our students to aim high and be all that they can be. Starting from the principle that all pupils arrive from primary school with strengths and talents which can be developed further. The ethos in the college is one of cooperation and effective learning. The senior pupils value what they've experienced during their years in the school, and it is heartening to see so many of them volunteering as study buddies for the younger pupils, assisting those who need reassurance to gain confidence. At present, unfortunately, you're not able to visit the campus in all its glory, but it is a safe and enjoyable place for pupils. That is why we ask our first and second year pupils to remain on campus during break and lunch times. That way we can offer supervised social spaces as well as a variety of lunchtime activities, such as in sport, games, music, drama, and indeed free Wi-Fi access. As a health promoting school, it's fantastic to watch the pupils enjoying impromptu games of football or rugby on both grass and artificial pitches, or just sitting around at picnic benches, relaxing and having a chat with friends. And if they've not done enough at lunchtime, a wide range of other after-school activities and study clubs also run. As head teacher of St Joseph's College, I'm extremely well supported by motivated and talented teams of staff who inspire pupils to give of their best. Staff are fully committed to helping our children become successful learners, confident individuals, active contributors, and responsible citizens wherever they may end up in the world. I very much look forward to welcoming the S1 of